everybody. This is Becca. Welcome to my first video. And I'm going to be doing a video on this look right here. It's kind of my everyday go-to makeup look for work and for church and anything else I might be doing that day. So I hope you enjoy. Good morning. Actually, it's like 2 p.m. here on my day off, but let's just play pretend. Okay, time to moisturize. I'm going to use this Pond's that I got for going out of town. It's just a travel size. I don't really care what moisturizer I'm using at this point in my life. I just need to get some water in my skin. So now I'm getting ready. I'm going to use this Pixi Glow Mist Skin Treats to kind of prep and prime my skin, I guess. I'm waiting for it to dry because it does take a little while. There's argan oil in it. I really like that. More moisture. Fix that hair. Got to make sure it's looking good, and it's not, but there's not much we can do about it. So moving on. I'm going to start with my Josie Maran Vibrancy Foundation, and I'm just using that little tiny bit. Actually, that's all I'm going to be using right now. It's Dynamic RG5, which I know is way too light for my skin right now, but I've never tanned before this summer, and this is the only shade that I have, so I'm just gonna bronze the heck out of it here in just a little bit. So, dotting it all over my face, getting the little foundation pox going, and blending. Blend, 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 blend. I feel like 90% of this video is gonna be blending, so if you wanna learn anything, I guess that's my tip. Blend. Going. Also, this foundation is going to be like super, super dewy. If you are not interested in, you know, making your skin kind of dewy looking, you probably want to go with a stick foundation, but I'm super dry, so this looks really nice for me. Sweet. Just a little bit dewy, a little bit luminous. And turning on the light, kind of blending it down on my neck so that the tan kind of blends into it, even though it's actually not the right color at all. But we're going to move on to concealer. And I use the NARS concealer. It's really, really creamy. And I don't know what shade this is. It is Chantilly. And it's like the lightest one that you can get from NARS. And it still works for me, even with a little bit of a tan. Cheese. Bubble. Getting that on my eyes, under my eyes. And we are looking good. Done. Gonna blend it out because, you know, blending is life. And grab that wet beauty blender and just pounce it all around that concealer, making sure to set that under eye area and get ready for eyeshadow. My foundation too, but I like the flat top of the poopy brush lately that I was using earlier. I'll put it in the description down below. I actually got it for free. It was really nice. And I just like the way that the beauty blender blends in concealer just because it's so much thicker than the foundation. And I use it as a primer for my eyes too. I use it underneath my eyeshadow to make it stick. Looking good. Yeah, blend, 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 blend. True Match. This is the only powder I have at this time, and this Real Techniques brush I use to just kind of set my under eyes so that the concealer doesn't crease. It's True Match powder in Neutral N1 Soft Ivory. And I like it. It does the job. So I'm planning on getting RCMA powder, just some translucent powder, because this is almost gone anyway, but it does the job. I like it. I also set the parts of my face that I'm going to put other powder on, like blush, contour, things like that, and just the places I don't want to be super shiny. Brushing out my eyebrows. They are super uneven today, but nobody wants to watch me do my eyebrows, so let's just go back to powder. And that brush was shedding on me, so I was getting the hairs off of my face. And I dropped it a few times. All those freckles. Can't get rid of them. The Josie Maran Vibrancy Foundation is actually super, super good. You can build the coverage. I don't usually wear full coverage just because I don't have a lot of blemishes. I know that I'm not trying to sound tacky, but... Okay, so this is my bronzer that I have. It is the wrong color for me. I don't know really what it is. It says matte bronze bronzing powder. And I'm using this little angle brush that I actually got at Sephora, and I think it's just a Sephora brush. But it does a really good job. It's a super dark color, but with a little tan, it kind of goes a long way. And I just do that right above where my top of my ear starts and into like the center of my cheek and under my cheekbones. I really like this brush because it like is super angled and it gets right in my cheekbone. Yep. This is an old brush, so old that it may have belonged to my mother, but I'm not really sure what it is. It says timeless on it, so I was trying to show you that there, and now we are going to bronze like a crazy person, trying to get it all up in that hairline, trying to make myself match my rest of my body. So. Also, there's me creating a jawline that I would never have without this bronzer. No double chin here today, oh no. Keep bronzing. And that's the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Definer. It's the only thing I've ever really had, so I love it, but I would be open to any comments and anything that you would recommend. It makes them super, super defined, and I don't know that I like that very much, and you'll see in just a minute, I kind of like to cover them up with concealer to blend them in a little bit, and it may also be that it's just the wrong color for me right now, anyway. But they stand out super with that. And just do a little dance, do a little jig. All right, listening to my music. And taking that concealer on a little tiny Real Techniques brush and just gonna put that right around them. Without trying to smudge the brown on the rest of my skin, I'm just gonna take that little brush again and blend it in. Just makes them look a little bit more soft. And I don't have any brow gel to set them, so I usually do this anyway just so that they like lay flat. And you'll see they kind of look a little bit better with my face after I do this because I feel like the color just matches a little bit better. Jeez. That's MAC Soft Brown. It's the best transition color for me when I am super, super pale. It comes out almost orange on my skin. It's fine. It's just a transition color, and I use it on this super old angle brush, and just there it is. I blend that all in my crease, and then I also just blend it everywhere else when there's less product. That's a flat top brush that I use to like really deepen up the crease whenever I want to make it a little bit darker, a little more defined. This is a MAC Paint Pot, and it's Pro Longwear. I use it underneath my foundation. MAC. It is. I don't really know what color it is, but I'll link it in the description below. It's like pink shimmer, which is, you know, pretty much my whole life. So pink shimmer all over the lid, and it just sets, you know, sets me up as the primer for the rest of my foundation, or the rest of my eyeshadow, which will also be pink shimmer. Shimmer, shimmer. And that angle brush is just completely flat. And I feel like it gets like a big cut crease in there that I can, you know, not get that up in the top of my crease. And that's a Buxom palette. I really like this shade right here. It's like, you know, pink shimmer. It doesn't have a name. I don't know what it is. Oh, it does. Champagne Buzz. And I just put that all over the center of my lid. This is, like I said, an everyday makeup look. I actually do this just about every day for work because I don't have to mess around with anything else. And I'm gonna take the lightest shade in here and try and put that in my corner. It's supposed to highlight, but it kind of matches my skin. So that's, you know, my life. It's called Silk Sheets, and there we have it. It is right there in the corner. And I like to take my finger and like dot it in there because it just really like makes the pigment show up a little bit better. If I want it in the inner corner highlight, and you'll see me do that right meow. There you go. Mm-hmm. And I'm gonna use this darker shade. It's just like a light brown, but it shows up dark on me. And I use that on that really flat brush. And it's a blending brush, but it's super, super flat at the top. So I just pack it on the like outer V of my eye and into my crease, and it just kind of makes it look a little bit more put together. Blend, 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 like I said. I don't know what I said. Maybe I'm singing. Not really sure. And same thing on this side. And I'm going to take that highlight and do my brow bone. But wait, I have a Becca highlighter that I got on sale for $14. Super great at Sephora. It's the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector Slim Light in the shade Pearl. and it's like creamy. It's like a little pen. It just goes everywhere I need it to, and I blend that out, and then I put powder over it so that it stays on all day, and it actually literally does. Can you see it right there? Highlight be popping. And then I do the other side. I put this highlight just about everywhere on my face, and just like with my highlight powder, we're going to be glowing. There we go. And that will set that a little bit better. At the end of this video, without filming, I actually had to put some more powder underneath my eyes because I had so much highlight, it looked like I was just like, it was crazy. So, I'm a little heavy-handed. Oh, okay, so I take that flat top kabuki brush again that I used on my eyebrows. Bad idea, but, you know, I'm just trying to blend it out. This is a really old brush, too, and it's a little blush brush. I'm not really sure where it's from, and that blush that I'm using is just about completely empty, so if you're not seeing any payoff, I'm not even sure what it's called. Sorry about that. And this is the only highlighter that I own because it's Becca. Hello. And it is Moonstone, and it's completely shattered. That's okay. It shows up really nice now that I have a little tiny bit of color on my skin, but before I feel like it even just like blended in with my skin and made me look like I was glowing, which I'm happy with, but I did want that highlight, you know, trying to call those aliens, so. Yeah. So the nose, pretty much everywhere. And then if I'm wearing a tank top during the day, summertime, I'm gonna do, you know, my collarbone, my shoulders. Yes, get it, put it on there, be glowing, okay. And all over my whole body, just take a little bath in that and done. Okay. All right, gonna fix the shirt. Elf eyeliner. This is just kind of like an eyeliner I'm using right now because it is super, super like gel-like, well not even gel-like, it's liquid. And I usually use a pen, the Sephora pens, and both of mine are empty, but I can still use it for the wing, so I don't ever use this Elf for the wing because I don't know how to do that. So basically I'm just drawing a Katy Perry little rainbow over my eyes, and then I will grab one of the pens from Sephora and just kind of lay it on the outer corner to make a nice little point. And you'll see here, this one, nope, it's empty, throw it away, and we're going to use this one instead. And it's Sephora thin tip, so I will lay it there on that side, it's a nice little edge, and then I just kind of bring it in towards the top of that little rainbow. Benefit Their Real Mascara. It is almost completely empty at this point. I'm gonna need to get some new makeup, you guys. If you have any suggestions, please leave it down below because I will be going to pick it up. This mascara I actually really do like, but I've just used the heck out of it and it's almost completely gone. So that's why I count, you know, 1,000 strokes before I end this part of the video. 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 1,000, and doing those bottom lashes too. Surprise, my mouth isn't hanging wide open while I'm doing this. You go, girl. Getting there. This is the telescopic mascara. Oh my gosh, you don't know who it's by. I'll put it down below. It separates my lashes so nicely, and it's so precise. I love it. It's actually what my mother-in-law uses, and so I just fell in love with it. That is the Sephora Beauty Amplifier Set and Spray, and it was empty, just like everything else in this video. So I used the Pixi Glow Mist again all over my whole entire body. And that's the finished product. So let's go over to the window. You can see maybe a little bit better. There's quite a bit of a shadow. But it's supposed to be kind of glowy. It's supposed to be highlighted. And if you want to see more, just let me know and give me any comments, any help, any questions you have down in the bottom, and like and subscribe for my first video. Thank you guys.